finding us a mansion prepared for himself, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
A reading from
greeting, the child in my womb leapt with joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord. And Mary said, my soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from that on all generations will call me blessed. For the mighty one has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the vaults of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up those who are lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and his descendants forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the one true and living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
In the previous portion of this passage, Mary is visited by the angel Gabriel. This visit is known as Annunciation because the angel tells her that she has found favor with God and that she will bear a son, which she will call Jesus. Her son will one day reign over all, and his kingdom shall have no end. Now Mary is perplexed since she is a virgin. How can this be, she asks. The angel explains to her that the Holy Spirit will come upon her, and therefore he will be holy and called the Son of God. Before he departs, the angel drops one more bombshell. Her elderly cousin, Elizabeth, once thought to be barren and expecting in her 6 months. For nothing is impossible to God. Mary's reply was simple. Here am I, servant of the Lord, let it be according to your word, which now brings us to the lesson that we heard a few moments ago. Mary went to her cousin right away, whose child would become known as John the Baptist. It is said that the child leapt with joy upon hearing Mary's voice. Mary wondered what was happening to her. Elizabeth, who was filled with the Holy Spirit, explained that she is blessed because she believed that the Lord would fulfill what was spoken to her. It is at this point that Mary speaks the words that have become known as Mary's son. Mary's song, or the Magnificat. In it, she gives praise to God for choosing her to give birth to the Messiah. God is indeed glorified, and his wonders and powers are told. In Mary's day, being visited by angels was to have God speak to you in such an indirect and personal way to his founder. The purpose of all of this is to prepare the world for the one, Jesus, who is coming in the name of the Lord. He who would one day redeem the world and suffer salvation and offer salvation to all through death on the cross. For us today, the story of Mary and her cousin shows us that once again having faith can work wonders. If God has spoken and they believe, the story also shows us again, as I have said many times, God often takes the ordinary person have been produced ordinary things. What is more to have the faith that Mary had? Taking the word of someone, in this case, an angel, and believing that God would fulfill his word. Well, we're acting supposed to already have that faith. Faith that if we believe in the word of God, that we will have a place in the kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. From the Son of Mary, we can learn from her gratefulness to God. We can be grateful to God for all that we have, and in spite of our often arrogance, pride, stubbornness, and delusions of grandeur, God still loves us. God loves us so much that when we do fact, those are the ones who will fall. We can take from Mary's song a sense of humility, that it will lead the humble and are exalted and not the proud or the arrogant. In the world around us, we see many examples of the world in which the Mary thinks about in her son. Tyrannical rulers, dominating world powers, stubbornness, and unwillingness to cooperate, proud hearts and stubborn wills. And it is not just the world that we find these days. If one is not careful, these things that Mary sings about also can creep up into our homes, our relationships, and yes, even our churches. Today is the fourth Sunday of Advent. The purple candle lit for today symbolizes peace and purity. It is the peace that the coming Messiah will bring to the world and to our hearts. It is the peace that we each need to give each other and ourselves. It is the purity of Christ that we would have embody within our lives each and every day. As we await with anticipation for the coming of the Messiah, we should ponder what this not only means for Mary and to those of her time, but what it means for us today as we continue to try and live as life and live as Jesus has commanded. If we are living in the way that He has commanded, then we should have a sense of peace after partaking of the body and blood of Christ. This is why no one should partake of communion if the heart is not right. If we have something against our brother or sister, or if we are living a life victorious that is contrary to the one that Jesus would have us to live, you cannot have peace in your life if any of these things are taking priority on your truly and strong bond with Christ and with each other. And with no peace, how can there be impurity? Mary and her cousin obviously had peace among them. Each of them was part of something that was bigger than themselves. They shared experiences that bind them and make them known to people for centuries to come. We're even talking about them still 2,000 years later. Now, with the humble being exalted, who would have known Mary if she had not been chosen by God to be the mother of our Lord and Savior? Take a moment to think of a time in which God has called you from humility, but maybe think of a moment when God had to bring you down from the self-imposed throne. On Friday, you will await the birth of Christ's child. Jesus is the only King and no other. Jesus walked among the people in humility, yet carried himself in a manner in which the people wanted to be with him wherever he went. He made their hearts leap. Just as John the Baptist leaped in his mother's womb at the sound of Mary's voice. The baby she would bear would be humble. He would be loved. The anticipation and waiting were finally over as we welcome the one in the world who would bring peace and goodwill to all. We welcome the one who is God incarnate. And we welcome the one who walked among the ordinary in order to make you a great people. When God walks among us, we are a great people. Let us continue to let God walk among us, with us, and in our hearts, our homes, and our churches. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
prophets.
We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism and forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayer of People, Form 5, can be found on page 389 of the Common Prayer. So let's pray for the church and for the world. In peace, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy. For the holy church of God, they may be filled with truth and love, and be found without fault at the day of your coming, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Michael, our presiding bishop, for Daniel, our bishop elect, for all bishops and other ministers, and for all the holy people of God, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Christ, that our divisions may cease, all may be one as you and the Father are one. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the mission of the church that is faithful witness and will increase the gospel to the ends of the earth. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the world, for the spirit of respect and forbearance and the growth among nations and peoples, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those in positions of public trust, may serve justice and promote dignity and freedom of every person. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, for prisoners, refugees, and all who are in danger, that they may be relieved and protected, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this congregation, for those who are present and for those who are absent, that we may be delivered from hardness of heart and show forth the glory of all that we do, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our enemies and those who wish us harm, and for all whom we have injured or offended, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have committed themselves to our prayers, for our families, friends, and neighbors, that being free from anxiety, they may live in joy, peace, and health, we pray to you.
Lord, have mercy.
For Charles, Gary, John, Damian, Eddie, Gloria, Regina, Levi, Carmen, Mildred, Cherish, Reginald, Charles, Geneva, Peyton, for Dorothy and Kane, for Colleen, Valerie, Ivy Grace, Julia, Cheryl, George, Calvin, Michelle, Jerlene, Robert, Gwendolyn, Elise, Margie, Maggie, Quincy, Oliver, and Victor. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the churches in this loose gospel cycle of prayer, St. Thomas Eastover, St. Stephen's Rivervale, our apostle Brian, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have died in the union of your church, and those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Rejoicing in the fellowship of the ever blessed Virgin Mary, blessed Luke, and all saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all life of Christ our God.
To you, Lord, our God.
For yours is the majesty, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Yours is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, now and forever.
Amen.
Let's confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, I'm a big believer.
Thank you.
righteousness of death in his body. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me."
Thank you. most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us